Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. In the previous lecture, we were discussing about the association analysis. I discuss about the what is the association, why do we require the association. I give the example that what is the Amazon, so.com or no.com, what they perform, what they do. They collect our profile or try to figure out the association, what is the hidden pattern. Hidden pattern between from us, hidden pattern in this data. Inshallah, we will discuss in detail about the association in chapter number 8. Just for the introduction, let me start it as the what association analysis as. Sorry, association analysis. Let me change the color. Okay. For example, here these are some data in the transaction database. Okay, for example, 10, 20, 30, 40, they represent Mr. Ahmed, Mr. Saad, Mr. Abdullah, Mr. Tariq. These are the transaction. A simple scenario is we are going to Panda, purchase some item, 10, they purchase some item, and whenever we pay the money, it generate the invoice, and this is how do proceed. Then what about the item bought? Item bought in Mr. Customer number 10 or Mr. Saad, he purchased ABC. ABC may represent sugar, milk, biscuit, etc. And for example, customer number 20, he purchased AC, AD, and BEF. In other words, A, B, C, D, E, F, these represent the item to be purchased by various customers. Now, these are the set of item. These are the set of item over there. What we need to, for example, here customer, here for example, these are the basic concept for the Venn diagram. The Venn diagram, this oval shape represents the customer buys milk. Let assume that the 10, 20, 30, they purchase milk presented by A. They purchase milk. What about the customer who purchased sugar? In other words, we can say 10, 20. These are the 10 and 20 who purchase sugar. C represents sugar. So it means these are the customers who purchase both milk and sugar. In other words, we can say 10 means the 10, 20. These are the custom. They are the customer 10 and 20 who purchase both. Now let's say what are the item set for here. Here the item set X, these are the item set X represent the item list as X1, X2, X3, X4. In other words, X1, X2, X3, X4 represent the A, B, C, D, milk, sugar, biscuit, etc. What we need to find all of the rule from X to Y means we need to find association from the list X to the list Y with the minimum confidence and support. It means these are two parameter performance measure. We will use this for the support and confidence. Find the find what are the outcome. Support will represent as small as confidence represented with C. Then what is support is it is a probability that a custom is the probability that a transition contain X union Y. Where X, what is X? It's just item set. Y is another item set. We need to find the support is X union Y. What is the probability that these are the? What is the probability that transaction contain both X union Y? Or in other words, we can represent probability P for the X union Y. Okay. Then we have another important measurement as the confidence. It's the conditional probability that a transaction having X also contain Y. How can we represent it as probability that the transition having X also contain Y? Then in order to find the relationship, what we are required? We require to find the minimum support, minimum confidence. Recall in the previous lecture I told about that, give the number of examples. One of the example I mentioned that the suppose as I purchased tomato, potato, chili, etc. I also purchased apple, milk along with the watermelon, etc. So obviously, if some customer purchase from list of item from the vegetable, he also purchase list of the item from the fruit. On the other hand, a customer may purchase 1 kilogram of apple. He also purchase 1 laptop. This is very rare case. 1 out of 100 customers who will have a similar combination. So it means we need to find, we must set some parameter benchmark. Minimum support is 50%, minimum confidence is 50%. These are our benchmark. What we required, we need to find the association rule from A to C. These are the association rule from A to C. A is the set of items, C is the set of item. Then what is A to C? Then these represent the confidence or support and the confidence. And what is a C to A? Well, A to C to A. Then, now for example, let me check how many, let me, Robin, how many customers have, how many customers, for example, I have A. We found have A, 1, A, 1, 2, 3. Three customers. Okay, three. Let me check it. Yes. Yes. How many AC were there? One AC, two AC. We have two AC. Two out of four have the combination of AC. What about the CA? How many CA were there? CA. See, two out of four represent 50%. What about the confidence? What about the confidence? The confidence. Let me try to under. For the confidence, we need to find what is represented. Probability of Y such that X has occurred. Then what we find that how many C were there? Two. How many A were there? Three. 3 out of 4, it means 2 divided by 3, 2 divided by 3 represents 66.7%. This we will discuss in detail chapter number 8. Now let's talk about what is the schematic view of the decision support system. In this support system, that it can be described as, suppose we have some, this is the system and these are our outside, these are the system outside. Let me, for example, here some database. These represent some relational database. In the relational database, it can be defined as some internal English from the organization. These are from the organization database. This one can be, for example, robots. We can see these are the database from some external, some industry, some market, some government data. Third one is about the private. In the private, for example, guidelines for specific decision and assessments. So the point is, because they are the relational, internal and external database or something private will be there. So we require some data management will be required. So that the we some data management will be required. In other words, we can say here we will manage data along with the DBMS data management. Here, for example, here about the model management. In the model management, we have some software packages that provide analytical capability. Here we have, for example, some external model were there. Then here we have, for example, intranet and extranet. What is intranet? They are all familiar about the internet. What about the intranet? Intranet means within the organization. These are within the organization. We can say network is available. So another word, these are the private network operated by the company. We, outside the organization, you cannot access the network. About the extranet, it is these are the internet accessible from outside, or some of the we can say another word, some of the access given to the partners. Then we have the user interface. It is a user interface represents interaction between the computer and the decider, the manager. How the user communicated, or the how the manager make a communication. Then we have the knowledge base management subsystem. What is knowledge base management system? In the knowledge base management subsystem, we have the knowledge base and the module management. this contain knowledge based system is this contain the facts along with the rules that exist between them. Then we also have the organizational knowledge base means the organization knowledge base, they represent the these are the means. I recall the example is, suppose I want to apply for the loan for the Samba Bank. They have their own organization knowledge, and it will be maybe quite different to, for the Al-Rayyan Bank Al-Rajhi Bank. So it may they represent the organizational knowledge to approve the loan. What is the rule that exists between for Al-Rajhi, it is different, for Samba it is different. So this is the diagram which shows the decision support system. Okay, now come to chapter number 2. Let's see. Although we have the brief overview for the data warehouse, for the data warehouse, what we require in chapter number 1, what we can again make a recall what we have discussed in the previous lecture. The data warehouse, as we saw in the previous lecture, data warehouse, it has four specific characteristics: subject oriented, integrated, time variant, and non-volatile, collected from the collection of the data in support of the management decision making. Means these database which contain the data, it will require to make a tool will make support for decision making, use for decision making. This is a definition given by Inman. Let's see what they call what we have discussed in the previous slide. As the subject oriented means integrated time rate. Subject oriented organized around major subjects such as product, sale, etc. Recall that I give the example, suppose the top management, they are interested about the what is the total sale for the kingdom, what is total sale just by the Mr. Manager, Mr. Top Manager who is in the kingdom is Ahmed Saad. What is the total product, what is the major product that will be sold, that will be covered in the subject. The second is about integrated means retrieve the data from the rest of the database and store in the consolidated database in the centralized. Constructed by integrating multiple heterogeneous data sources, had multiple means all over the entire organization. They retrieve the data and integrate it, store in the consolidated, then in the maybe in the relational database of flat files. Then these data which are in the form of relation database or the flat file form. Then the time variant, all of the data they are timestamp, means all of the data they have the timestamp. So why do we require timestamp? But might be possible we are interested about the why the sale was dropped 5 years ago. So it contains the element time explicitly and implicitly. About the non-volatile, once data they enter in the system, they will never be deleted. Required only two processing in data accessing is initially loading the data and query. Just read. We do not have the provision for the delete. Now, let's make a comparison between the what's the difference between the data warehouse, data in the data warehouse, and data for the operational database. What is the difference between them? Let's see. The tool required for the data warehouse is OLAP, online analytical processing, and the tool required for the operation database OLTP, online transaction processing. What is OLTP? Major task of traditional relational DBMS. It is some traditional or routine work, day-to-day operation routine. For example, someone purchase inventory, banking. In the banking, for example, deposit the money, withdraw the money. In the here in the inventory system, panda they are interested about them, how many product they have sold, what are the remaining product, so that they can make the advance order to the supplier. Yeah, the example. What about the OLAP? OLAP is a tool required, for the data warehouse. The task is it is used for the data analysis and decision making. Now let's make the comparison. What's it between OL, AP, and OLTPS users? Who are the users? Anyone? The other user. The routine activity were there. Cashier. Then about the here. What about who are the user? Knowledge worker. Because they need to be dealing about the decision making. For the decision making, obviously some knowledge worker will be required. Then function to daily operation, routine operation. There function routine operation. I purchase something from Panda. This is the routine operation. About here, the function is support, decision support. Decision support means we found some problem. For this problem, we need to make the solution that requires decision support. Then about the DBA, database design. About the database design is application oriented. What are the different application? Database design application oriented as what is the application? For example, I generate the invoice. I purchase from the Panda. I pay the money. He give me the invoice. It is the application oriented. Here the subject oriented. What about the data? Current data. Here in the operational database, they are more interested only in the current data. In the Panda, they are not interested at the outlet or the branch. 5 years ago, what was the sale? No, they are more interested only for the current one. Current sale, up to date current sale. About the detail. Obviously, they must have the very detail. Very detailed. Might be possible. I purchase 10 items, and one day after I told that okay, these two items please take back. So it means they must have the detail. In the very detail here, their data is historical purpose, history summarized with some aggregation summary. Then recall that in the previous chapter number one, we talk about the multi-dimensional, integrated, consolidated. So these are the feature for the data. What about the axis? In the axis, we can read and we can write. Here we cannot. Here we have a lot of scanning because we need to find a solution. For the solution, we make a scanning for the database. Unit of work is small, short, and simple transaction. Purchase if I am talking about the bank, deposit the money, withdraw the money, transfer the money. And here we have the very complex query because we need to find the answer, find the query, solve some problem. Database size is about the 100 GB, 100 in term of GB, for example. Whereas here we have the several terabytes of database data size is there. About the metrics is transaction. Here we talk about transaction throughput. Here the query, we need to answer the query or we need to get the response for our query generated. Now let's talk about the how means. Although we are much familiar, let me first tell you what is this. Here what we need to recall in chapter number one, we talk about the multi-dimensional or something, the concept for the cube. In chapter number one, I give the brief overview, but we are not much familiar for multi-dimensional. One dimension, second dimension, third dimension, third dimension. We are not much familiar about the multi-dimension. Then what should we do? It means we need to have the concept from the table, which is the two dimension, to the data cube, which is two or more than two, with the three or more than three dimension. For the table, as we are familiar about, a table consists of some rows, number of rows and number of columns. We are much familiar about the concept. A data warehouse is based on that multi-dimensional data model. We are talking about the data warehouse. These data warehouse is used for the decision making, and the model will be used as a multi-dimensional, more than one dimension. We are just familiar about the two dimension. Rows and column. Then obviously we need to have some concept. How can we proceed from two dimension to three dimension or more dimension, which views the data in the form of data cube. Here in the multi-dimensional, we view the data and analyze data in the data cube. I just show you the data cube. A data cube. What is data cube? It's a such a sale. For example, we make a data cube for the sale. We are interested about the what are the different what are the different sale means sale of the product, sale of the television, sale of the vegetable, sale of the, for the take simple scenario for the panda, tail, sale for the vegetable, sale for the food, sale for the electronic item, sale for the shampoo. These are the sale, sale for non-electronic item, sale for the furniture. Moreover, we also enter the it's about the sale in the month of January, sale in the month of February, sale in the month of March, etc. We may analyze the data cube as sale for the Riyadh city, sale for the Ulayya road, sale for the kingdom. So this lies by the data cube. So we are viewing, visualize, or we are with the view of the sale, allow the data to model and view multi-dimensional. So this data cube we may model and viewed as a multi-dimension as. So in other words, we can say this data cube has a multi-dimension as, for example, the item, time, location. What are the attribute for the item? Item name, item type, etc. What are the attribute for the time? It means one dimension, second dimension, third dimension. Day, just Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, in term of week, week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, month in the January, February, March, April, quarter, quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and the year. In term of location, we can say Ulayya Street, we can say King Abdul Aziz Road. If we can say in term of city, for example, the Riyadh City, Jeddah City, Dammam City. In term of country, we can say India or the Emirates, etc. I will show you in the next slide, for example, here. So it means here, you can see here we have the in term of item of product, television, PC, DVD. In term of day, time, second dimension, first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter. In term of city or location, Mecca, Medina, Quds, and make this is the summation. So in order to analyze for the data cube, we need to have two types of table over there. The first category is about the dimension table, the second category is about the fact table. In the dimension table, we have these are the dimension tables over there. More than one table. Fact table contain the measures and what we want to measure. We want to measure in term of sale, total sale, average sale, minimum sale, maximum sale, sale for the just Ulayya Road, then and the count, etc. And what are the keys? These keys be required so that we can make the correlation between the different tables. Obviously, as you are familiar about the primary key, secondary key, if we have more than one table, in order to connect this table, what we required, some key will be required, primary key, foreign key will be required. Now let's talk about the how the 2D view, 2D two dimensional view of the scale sales cost evolution, two dimension view. Let's talk about the, as we saw in the cube table, as quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and the mega summation. And this quarter 1 for the city of Mecca have the how many units in term of sale, we can say 670 riyal. The television is 670 for the first quarter. Each of the quarter consists of 3 months. What about the PC? 200. What about the DVD? Is 500 plus 200 plus 670 is equal to total is 1072. In other words, what about the quarter two? These are the value for the quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Or in other words, we can say this is the make a summation for 670 plus 400 plus 800 plus 200, 2070. We also have the summation. So in other words, we can say we have summation term of column, we have the summation term of rows. Then we are familiar about the two dimension. You are already much familiar how to work with the Excel sheet. Now let's talk about the representation, relational representation of the pivot table. How can we represent the pivot? Recall in chapter number 1, I talk about the pivot. Pivot is visualization. There are four operations over there. Aggregation. We talk about the aggregation, selection, then dice, and the pivot. These are the four operations in the data warehouse. So pivot is visualization. First quarter television is 670. First quarter PC is 200. Then what is your total first quarter? Sale is 1,370, 1,370. So in other words, with the representation of the relation representation of we can show the pivot table as. In other what we are trying to do, actually we are familiar about the two dimension of working with the Excel sheet in which we have the rows and columns over there. What is our intention? Our intention is we want to work with the data cube, whereas the data cube is three dimension or more than three dimension. Then what we required, some mechanism will be required, so that how can we move from table to the data cube. This is our intention. Now let's talk about the again make a review. These are three dimensional view of the sales cube. It means all of this cube and the sub cube. This is the whole cube and these are the sub cubes over there. What we are dealing, we want to make the analysis with the sale. Then in the here, for example, we can say in this dimension we talk about the in term of item or product. What are the item or product? Were there television, PC, DVD? Okay, this shows the sale for the first quarter for the television. What about this sale for the first quarter for DVD? What about this sub cube represent? This sub cube represent sale for the third quarter with the PC. Then what is that? This is sum. Make a summation of all of this. This is a make a summation of all of this one. So in other way, for the whereas what does this cube represent? It is a sum of all of this sale for the product TV, PC, DVD for the first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, for the whole year, for the just Makkah region. This is the total sale for all of the country, for all of the time, and for all of the product. Now in the here it means now we are familiar about the what is the concept for the data cube. We need to come another important concept for the lattice of cuboid. What is the lattice of cuboid? Okay, we are not familiar about this terminology. What does it mean? Lattice cuboid, it is a data cube viewed as a lattice of cuboid. It means this is a data cube. We view in term of the lattice of cuboid. Each cuboid represent different group by. There are the different groups for there. Or cuboid correspond. These are the cuboid correspond to the cube. They are the cube. They are the cuboids for there. Let's say for example here if we are trying to for example here we have the zero dimensional cuboid. We have a specific name for the zero dimensional cuboid as the apex. Then we have the one dimensional cuboid, two dimensional cuboid, three dimensional cuboid. Since we have in this slide we only discuss about the three dimension, so it means the highest dimension represent the base cuboid. What is the base cuboid? What is the apex? Apex means zero dimension and base means maximum number of dimension. Let's started with the zero dimension as the all. Started with all. Then what are the different here? Recall in the previous slide as we have product, for example the date and the city. One dimension, second dimension, three dimension. For example, we need to make the analysis for this one. Then come back here for the front. One dimension cuboid is we individually it is by the one by one, just the product, just the date, just the city for the single dimension here. Then what about the single dimension, sorry, what about the two dimension? In the two dimension, make a group of two. Since how many dimension were there, we have the product, date and city. Just make a group of two: product date, product city, product date city. Make a combination of two dimension. Here the three dimension. Three dimension means make a dimension of all of three: product, date, city. So in this slide, what we have discussed, we discuss about the lattice of cuboid. What is lattice of cuboid? These data cube, they are viewed as a lattice of cuboid. Cuboid correspond. These are the cuboids. They corresponds toward the data cube. Now let's talk about, in the previous slide we talk about the three dimension. Do we have more dimension? Yes, we have more dimension. In the, what are the three dimension were there? In the previous slide we have the three dimension were there: item, city. For example, we talk about the item, item, city, date and time, etc. Here in this slide, for example, if we will add one more, that is the supplier. Who is the supplier for the laptop? The supplier from the laptop, for example, can be, it can be Acer, can be HP, etc. Then now how again we try to understand the concept for the letter of cuboid for the four dimension. Obviously, as the number of dimension will increase, the complexity will also be increased. For the started, again they started with the zero dimension, which is the apex, then highest dimension, which is the base. For the zero dimension cuboid, what we have, we started with the all. Then for the one dimension, each of the dimensions explicitly represent time dimension, item dimension, city dimension, and it is something new, that is supply dimension. Then second dimension is make a group of two dimension one by one. Here we have the time item, time city, then we have the time supply, item city, and the item supply, and the city supply. What are these? These are the two that make a group of three form dimension. Then what about the make a group of three? Here make a group of three mean time item city, time item supplier, then the time city supplier, item city supplier. So what are these? In this three dimension cuboid, we make a group by of three dimension. Finally, then we have the base of four dimension. Obviously, there the four dimension are time, city, item, city supplier. So just come back to the previous slide. Here in the three dimension, here this is the cube for the three dimension. Whereas what we have, if you have the four dimension, then how do we proceed? We have the mechanism. So that's obviously, as the number of dimension will be increases, it will be more difficult. Now let's talk about the cube. What is a cube? What is the how many cuboids means how many cuboids represented by the T in n dimension. Recall that in the previous slide we talk about the 10 dimension, product dimension, location dimension, and supply dimension. We can, you can add as the number of increases. So here they are the n dimension of data cube, with each of the dimension of h level of hierarchy, h level of hierarchy. For example, let's talk about time dimension. A time dimension may contain the year. A year consists of multiple quarter, q1, q2, q3, q4. Each of the quarter consists of the 3 months: January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September. Then each of the month consists of 4 weeks. Each of the week consists of 7 days. So these represent the level of hierarchy. Level of hierarchy. Then how do we compute how many cuboid required? Number of cuboid required represented by T. This is the formula: product from I1 to N. Li, what is L, represent the number of level, and what is N? N represent number of dimension. And number of dimension n plus 1. This is the formula. So the example is, if n equal to 10, if we have 10 dimension, each of the dimension has only one level, then 1 l equal to 1, 1 plus 1, then power, just make the power of 10, 2 power 10. On the other hand, if we have increased the number of level 4, then 4 plus 1 power 4 plus 1 power 10. As you can see, as the number of hierarchy will increase, or as the number of dimension will increase, number of cuboids is something million or billion, more than billion. For example, here how many cuboids were there? For example, how many levels were there? Single level. How many what is n dimension is equal to, then number of dimension is equal to 4. 1 plus 1, let me, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 power 4 equal to 16. So we have 16 cuboid, total 16 cuboid were there. Now let's talk about them. So in other words, in simple, we can say as the number of qubits will increase, as the number of dimensions will be increased, then level is increased, or the dimension is increased, number of qubits will also be increased. Now let's talk about the relational modeling of data warehouse. Relational of data warehouse. It means we are trying to understand the concept of the data warehouse. Although fundamentally data warehouse work with the data cube, then we want to make the model with the relational data. What is relational data? In this we have the number of rows and number of columns. Come back. Data modeling of the data, it means you recall that in the start of the lecture I told about the two different type of tables were there. Recall. I talk about the dimension along with the measurement of keys. Dimension table and fact table. In the start of the lecture I mentioned that. We need to discuss about the three different type of database modeling. Star schema, snowflake schema, and the fact constellation. What are the properties of each of this one? In the star schema, a fact table is in the middle, connected to a set of dimensional table. Okay, then just read this one. Then I will discuss each of these different type of schema one by one. Here in the star schema, just star. We are much more familiar about the star. Is something. Here central we have star, the schema similar to. So in the center we have the fact table and surrounded by the dimension table. We will discuss in the next slide. In the snowflake schema represent the dimensional hierarchy by normalizing dimension table hierarchy. Which means here in the snowflake schema we have also the mechanism for the hierarchical table. Recall that for example a month consists of number of weeks, a week consists of number of days. So these are hierarchies were there. So in the snowflake system we have the mechanism for the hierarchy. Each level of dimension represent, so each level of the dimension represent a table. Then we have the fact constellation. In the fact constellation we have the multiple fact table share the dimension table. Here in the star schema we have a single fact table. Here is in the fact constellation multiple more than one fact table is there and is shared by dimension table. It will be clear when I will show you. As we saw, what is the fundamental concept for the star schema is the effect table surrounded by the dimension table. These are dimension table. Recall that in the previous slide we talk about what are the different type of dimension were there. Time dimension, item or product dimension, location or city dimension. We saw in the previous cube side. Then here for example we have the new dimension, we have the branch dimension. Or in the qubit, I give the example for the four dimension as a supplier dimension. If we have, for example, dimension. Now let's talk about. So it means each of these dimension, represented by relational table. Relational table means something about the Excel table or relation. Relation number of cube, number of column. Let's see what are the attribute for the item dimension. Item and dimension. What we have the item key. What are the different item name? Television. TV, laptop, etc. What is the brand? The laptop, for example, television is from the Samsung brand. About the type and supplier type. In other, we don't leave this one. We just focus at the in the here we have the four dimension: item, location, branch, and table. Each of the dimension represent a separate relational table. Table were there, and what are the attribute were there? Item key, item name, brand, supply, brand type, supply. These are the attribute for the item. What about the attribute for the location? Location key, state, then city, then state or province, then the country. What about the attribute for the time is time key, day of the week, month, quarter, year. What are the branch? Only a branch, for example, we can say only branch. A branch key, branch name, branch type, etc. As we are familiar about, since we have more than one table, separate distinct table were there. Time, these are different table were there. these tables have the attribute word there. If the attribute can be represented by separate column, it means some key will be required so that it can connect together. So it means this table connect with the sales fact table as the with the item key. This table with this key or some primary key, some primary or foreign key will be required. This table make a connected with the this table by the some key will be required. So item key, we can say, then we have time key, branch key, and the location key. Or in other words, we can say these are the keys. What are the attribute for the fact table? It consists of the number of keys along with the measurement. What are the measurement? Are there number of units sold? For example, the Olaya brand, they sold 10 unit of television. Total sale, what is the total sale of the King Abdullah's branch? Then we can say total sale, every sale. What is the every sale? So in other words, we can say these consist of the keys along with the measurements. Recall that in the first slide I told you about this one. Here we have the dimension table, consist of the other dimension along with their attribute, and another one is a fact table. Fact table consists of the measurement, average, minimum, maximum, total, count, along with the keys. These keys will be required so that we can correlate different tables. So okay, we will stop right now. Inshallah, we will continue. So thanks of you. Thank you very much. Thank you.